Hey everyone, welcome to our Nowruz and Harmony Day celebration at Edith Cowan University. I'm Oran, a member of the Baha'i Society at ECU. Edith Cowan University prides itself in its diverse student body, which is a reflection of the multiculturalism of Australia. With students from various backgrounds and experiences, ECU embodies the rich tapestry of cultures that make up our nation. Today, we'll be interviewing fellow students here at the university about their culture and about their thoughts on diversity. We'll be sharing food from various cultures and having discussions with people about how we can foster greater harmony in our communities and in the world at large.
Tell us your name and where you're from.
I'm Mari, I'm from Iran.
How do you think embracing cultural diversity contributes to a stronger community or society?
I think that it's going to be good if people can respect to other people's values and respect to their religion, to everything. I think that just respect and knowing that, giving true information about their backgrounds, you know, they rise a chance of being friends and having more friends in the same culture. And it's nice. I think that that's going to be something that can be helpful.
Yes. Yeah. So you think by people sort of embracing the cultural differences and having a curiosity to learn about each other
exactly.
will help to foster unity.
Yeah.
That's wonderful.
When you just one by one, you have face-to-face connection and you talk, you know, you will understand, you feel the emotion. They will find out that there is no difference between people.
In what way can open-mindedness help you interact and understand individuals of diverse backgrounds and beliefs? It's a big question, Anna.
Right. When you are open-minded to people's differences, you're being respectful to those differences.
Yes.
It's so easy for people to fall into the bias and hold some certain negative, like stereotypes against them.
Yep.
Right. And that could create like a dissonance. It can create conflict between those people. But the truth is, we are very globalized at the moment. You've got social media. You've got people able to fly across different countries, and well, everyone has the right to express their individuality, their cultures, their different beliefs, ideas and such. And if we want to live in harmony, since it's Harmony Day,
yes,
we do want to be open-minded in the fact that be open-minded to able to accept that differences and be willing to accommodate each other's differences.
I think the only way for us all to be harmonious in diversity is accepting each other's values, traditions, beliefs, and not, you know, judging everyone, just accepting and allowing people to explore themselves and be accepted part of society with their own values and faiths.
Have you ever tried a food from a different culture that you ended up loving? What was it?
I've tried Afghan food and their Afghan rice was amazing. When we were back in high school, everybody would literally bring food from their own household and just literally have a whole picnic at recess.
That's so beautiful.
Sitting around. So yeah, I've tried different. I've tried Malaysian food, which I'm obsessed with, and Afghan food. I've even tried, I even brought in my own culture, which is, I'm from Somalia, so I would like bringing samosas and like rice and stuff like that, and everyone really enjoyed it.
Oh,
really nice.
That's so sweet. Vincent, how do you define harmony within the university setting?
Oh, I define harmony as coexisting together in peace, working together towards a common goal, shared values, shared beliefs. Yeah, and making sure you are your brother or sister's assistant in everything, either emotionally, financially, or spiritually. Yeah, I believe in ECU, many students come from different countries and exist harmoniously. I've never experienced any problem. Every student here, they have different beliefs, but they have common goal here.
How can education be used as a tool to promote unity in diversity from a young age? I think the more we learn, the more we're forced to question a lot of the time. I definitely feel like since becoming a student, I've learned more about what I don't know than what I do know. And so I think questioning is important to unify sort of diversity, in the sense that we can ask each other different questions and learn from each other. And when we do that, it's less divisive. It's not like we're having groupthink. We're not thinking about our own values so much. We're considering other people. So I think that's why education is important.
We had a wonderful event today talking with all the different students that came and visited us on campus with our beautiful tray of delicious foods. It was a wonderful initiator for people to come and talk with us. And it was lovely to have an activity that people could come and partake in and to have some one-on-one time with talking to people individually about what their thoughts on harmony and unity were.
Yeah, it was great. I think these are principles and things that everyone can agree with, and having that on display with food and talking about harmony naturally draws people in because they see the beauty in it, and it sort of flows into being able to talk about like our faith and our new year and share all our beliefs and ideals.
Oh, and wearing all the national dress as well. It's a wonderful conversation point to get the conversation started with people.
In terms of improvements, I think it's just about scaling it up. We can have more food, represent more cultures, maybe even bring people in to represent their own cultures, because we ran out of food pretty quickly, and it would be great to just keep it going longer and have more people join us.
Yeah, food is pretty popular. I found also with the questions, our questions were very detailed, and maybe just having a variety of some simpler ones or easier ones so people didn't feel so intimidated to answer them as well would be great. But all in all, it was a super great event, and if you're thinking of running one like this, you should.